Okay, so you see, what is the first step? Preferences, structural, you say okay. Next step, preprocessor, element type, add, edit, delete, you add. What is the element? Beam. Two node 188, you say okay. Element type is defined. Next step, material properties. Material models, structural, linear, elastic, isotropic. What is the E value? Either 2.1 E5 or you can even specify 210 E3, right? Either this or this. 0.27. You say okay. Close it. What is the next step? Section. You have to define a section. Section of what? Beam. Common sections. Rectangular is selected. Breadth and height. 200 and 300. Okay. Section is defined. Next. Model. We have to create nodes. Create what? Nodes in active coordinate system. First node at origin. Apply. Second node. 3000. Apply. Third node. 4500. Apply. Fourth node, 6000. You say okay. All these are done. If it is not visible, you press fit view. Nodes are done. Elements. Create, not nodes, elements. Auto numbered through nodes. Through what nodes? First node, second node. Click apply. First element is created. First, second, click apply. Okay, first node, second node, apply. So this is first element, second element, third element, right? You press okay. Now nodes and elements are done. Next, modeling is done. Now loads, define loads, apply, structural. Firstly, we are going to constrain it here, right? Simply supported beam, displacement on nodes, which node? First and last, right? You say okay. He will ask you what degrees of freedom to constrain. Not all degrees of freedom. UX, UI, UZ, translations are fixed. Rotation in X and Y are also fixed. Z is free to move. You say okay. So you see symbols have come. Now after displacement, this that UVL, pressure, pressure on what? On beams directly. Which beam? This beam. You say okay. He will ask you, at node I and J, basically here and here. So at I, you have 0, right? At J, how much? 40 kilonewton per meter. Equivalent is newton per mm, right? That 10 power 3 have canceled out. So you have 40. So we have to give 40 on beams. Yeah, I'm repeating again, on beams. This beam, okay. 0 at one end, at the other end, 40. 0 and 40, right? Okay. Clear? Clear, right? Many were here, right? So pressure is done. Now point load of 80 kilonewton, right? At third node. So structural force. Force where? On node. Which node? Third node, right? You say okay. He will ask you for direction and value. Fy is the direction. Minus 80,000 newtons. You say okay, that arrow will come. So loads and all other things are defined, right? So now we can solve it. So all this is done. So this was all pre-processing, right? What we did was pre-processing. Now solution, solve, current LS. He will ask you to review. You say okay, solution is done. Close, we'll even close this command status. Now we'll view the results. Solution phase is done. Now general post processor, plot results. You want to plot the deformed shape. He'll ask you either only deform or both. Deform plus undeform, we will see. You say okay. You see that blue is the deformed beam because of the UVL and load. Any other result to plot? SFD and BMD. So for that, what is the procedure? You have to define a table, element table, define table, add, you go to last by sequence number. This is a software code SMISC 3. Apply. Again, SMISC. No, 3 and 16, right? For BMD. So we'll apply. Again, by sequence number 6. You say apply. And again, by sequence number 19. You say okay. So it's 3, 16, 6, 19. Now we'll see the SFD and BMD. How to see that? Again, plot results. Contour plot. Line element result. Combination 3 and 16. 3 and 16. Leave all the other things as same. You say okay. This is your BMD. BMD. Now SFD. Combination is 6 and 19. You say okay. This is your SFD. Right? Want to capture the image? You go to image capture. You say okay. It'll ask for file name. You give it, you save it, and that PDF will be generated. Right? Okay. No, actually, you are supposed to